Okay, let's talk about APRV, okay? Specifically how to set it with the Puritan embedding, okay? So the first thing we'll do is we'll talk about something that everyone gets, syscontrol. And then we're gonna compare it to APRV, and then we're going to show how to adjust for blood gases, and then talk about things like pressure support, okay? So let's say that we have an assist control. We have a rate of 12, tidal volume of 500, and then our PEEP is 5, okay? So there's our order doctor setting. So we're going to have a plane that is time over pressure. Okay. And we're going to draw the waveform of what this breath looks like. Okay. So we have our waveform for assist control. This is our PEEP of 5, of course. Okay. This is our peak pressure, which in a normal patient, it's probably in the teens, okay? But if we're sick, we get a sicker patient that's ARBs, we get much significantly higher peak pressures, right? Because their lungs aren't as compliant. So this is going to represent the tidal volume, the 500 mils for every breath, right? So there's our waveform for assist control. So pretty straightforward, but let's look at APRV. Okay, the different kind of settings we're going to have. So APRV, typical bed settings for APRV, we have our PEEP high, we have our PEEP low, time high, and then time low. Okay, you notice there's no respiratory rate set, right? Because we're talking about now time constants. We're setting a time constant. We're having this patient breathe a certain duration, and we're going to manipulate that from there, okay? So peep high. Peep high is usually set by taking the plateau pressure from an assist control patient and going from there, okay? We usually cap it around 30. Sicker patients, we'd have 35 a peep sometimes. But usually in the 20s is where we'll start a patient, 25, okay? So let's say we're going to start this patient at 20, high PEEP of 20. Low PEEP, usually around 0 or under 5, okay? Because this is not real. This PEEP is really the baseline, okay? And if you'll notice when I draw the waveform, we usually don't reach baseline on the low PEEP, okay? So there's always kind of a little built-in extra PEEP. So anything that you add above 0, you know, we're adding more. We're not allowing them to exhale as much. Okay, and that's where the gas exchange is going to happen at the bottom of this PEEP low. Okay, so we want to keep a conservative. Zero is kind of the standard lately now. Okay, time high. Time high is the duration that we're going to have the patient take their top breath at the PEEP high. Okay, and this is where we're going to pop up on the LV line. The PEEP high is going to be around 5.5 seconds. This is kind of an aggressive order. You know, we're talking about this patient, we want to pop them open. We're not playing around. Okay. Time low is going to be usually under a second. Okay. And this works out to about an IDE ratio of probably 8 to 1, something like that, right? Which sounds uncomfortable, but this isn't like the old days where we put an inverse ratio on a assist control patient and we'd have to paralyze them. Okay. This is spontaneous breathing. And I'll show you where this 8 to 1 happens. So it's not going to look too extreme. Okay, so now we have our waveform. Okay, so a little bit different from assist control, the waveform for APRV looks like this. Okay, you see that? There's our waveform. Now let's break down each of these, where these fit on the waveform. Okay, PEEP high, it's right here, or PIP, there. PEEP high is 20, it's about right here, okay? This area. PEEP low is here, 0, okay? And you notice this is 0, okay? But we're not reaching baseline because we don't have time, we don't really give them that much time to exhale, so there's a little bit of air left in the alveoli, and that's the whole point. We're going to pop it open. We're going to use an open lung approach. Okay, so here's our 0 of PEEP. Here. Time high is this duration. and it is 5.5 seconds, is here, where we're going to pop open the alveoli. The time low is this duration down here. We are half a second, or we're going to reach zero baseline to try to kind of blow off that CO2. Okay, and that's what we're going to set up. Now, why don't we set a rate? Okay, the rate is going to be determined by these time constants. Okay, so we have 60 seconds. Okay, and in 60 seconds, how many times are we breathing? Okay, it's easy. You're just going to add the time high and the time low together. 5.5 plus 5 is 6, right? 6 goes into 60 10 times, and that's our respiratory rate, right? That's our set respiratory rate. That's if they're not spontaneously breathing, which is not what we want to do, because we want them to spontaneously breathe, because this is kind of just a big CPAP, okay? So what we want to do is have them spontaneously breathe. The breaths are going to happen above PEEP. Okay, these little breaths up here, okay, it's going to vary. These little breaths, some of these will be 100 mils. Okay, and some of these breaths are going to be larger, some are going to be smaller. But this is where we pop up in the alveoli. That's where the magic happens, is above PEEP, right? So we don't want to snow them. We don't want to paralyze this patient. Otherwise, we're just making them breathe in a goofy way, right? So let's say that we have our patient dialed in, and then we get a blood gas, okay? And it's not great. Okay, we're getting 60 CO2, and 100% we're getting 100, which is not great either. No metabolic issues yet. Okay, but this is our blood gas. So what are we gonna do if the doctor goes, trauma doc goes, hey, what do you think we should do? Okay, what you don't want to do is go, let's turn up the rate, let's blow that off. Okay, because once you turn up the rate, you're gonna screw with this, you're gonna screw with the time constant, and then we're gonna throw it all off. So the best thing to do, you got to treat it like a BiPAP or like a pressure support, where we're going to increase the tidal volume. Okay, we're going to increase the delta between this and this. This tidal volume, it's above 20 PEEP. It's probably around 489 or whatever. Okay, whatever that we're looking at, whatever we're measuring. So we want to increase the PEEP high. It's the first thing we want to do. Okay, it's the easiest way. Without screwing around with all the time constants is what we want to do, to blow off CO2. It's also going to help oxygenation at the same time. So it's a win-win. We want to do that. We want to increase PEEP high. That's the easiest thing to do. Okay. You can also adjust the time low. Okay, it's going to give us more releases, as we say. Okay, it's going to give us more releases to blow off the CO2. But I would try this first. Okay, and then once you exhaust this, maybe we start manipulating the time low, okay? So, pretty easy, okay? Adjust one thing. Let's talk about something that we're dealing with the docs ordering pressure support. So sometimes you'll get these settings, and usually you'll get a time low. You won't really get a time, you won't get a time high setting, right? You'll dial it in, and this will adjust, okay? But you'll also get a pressure support order. You have 20, let's say it's 23. Okay, you get this 20 over 0, time low 0.5, 23. Okay, so where does that look like on the graph? Right? What does that look like? So let's say we set our pressure support at 23. On the Puritan Bennett, you'll see this box, 23 pressure support. Okay, you'll see it's above PEEP. Okay. Now, which PEEP are we talking about? They're referring to the low PEEP, okay? So this is above low PEEP, okay? So this has to be greater than this. This plus this has to be greater than this for this even to register as pressure support. Because pressure support happens above high PEEP, okay? Whenever they take a breath, we give them a little bit of 3 extra centimeters of water to help knock this out, right? 23 PEEP. Now, do we need to set this? Is it necessary? I don't think so. I think setting this to 23 does the trick, right? But, well, doctors are playing with this right now. Now, what doesn't make sense sometimes is they'll set a pressure support that's below this. So every once in a while, doctors will set a pressure support order that doesn't make sense. For instance, let's say instead of 23, which is 3 above the high PEEP, they set a pressure support of 18, okay? So what would that do? If you set this pressure support of 18, And remember, this is above low PEEP. Okay, so if we go low PEEP and we go to 18, 18 is about right here. Okay, so that doesn't even reach. That doesn't even reach high PEEP. So it's kind of unnecessary to do this because we're not actually adding to anything. Okay, it has to be above the high PEEP. So at least here we're getting 5 centimeters of water. Okay, and we're doing above high PEEP.